बोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय, श्रीमद सद्गुरु सरकार की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय। अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ब्रजे वसन्तं नवनीत चौरं गोपांगनाना चडुकूल चौर अनेक जन्मार्जित पाप चौरं चौराग्रगण्यं पुरुषं नमः। नमः कमलनाभाय, नमः कमलमालिने, नमः कमल पादा, नमस्ते कमलेक्षण यो ब्रह्मानं विरधाति पूर्वं यो वै वेदांश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तद्ध्वं हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। बोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय, श्रीमद सद्गुरु सरकार की जय, राधा रानी की जय, श्रीमद भागवत महापुराण की जय। आदरणीय पूजनीय पंडित जी, पंडित मंडली, विप्र मंडली, प्रिय सज्जनों, प्रिय भक्त समुदाय, महानुभाव, मोस्ट वर्शिपेबल पंडित जी और पंडित, डेवस डिवोटीज ऑफ सुप्रीम लॉर्ड द डिवाइन सोल्स, फर्स्ट लेट मी से राधे राधे टू ईच एंड एवरीवन एंड माय प्रणाम, माय हम्बलेस्ट प्रोस्ट्रेशंस टू ऑल ऑफ यू। एज यू ऑल विल नो, आई एम श्योर, वी ऑन द स्पेशल तीरथ, the special yatra, spiritual journey, divine journey, delving into the pages of this most wonderful divine text, Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran, which is Bhagwan Shri Krishna himself personified. Bhagavat Mahapuran is a translation of Vedas, hence it is also called Pancham Ved. So we are indeed very blessed. We have undertaken the solemn oath to go on this journey of 21 sessions of Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran, the divine journey. Today is the 20th, we have one more session to go. It's only by the grace and blessing of the Supreme Lord this is all possible, and the Guru. As we begin, as we do every night, first we do Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran Sumiran. Sumiran means remember, meditate and listen. Remember the Supreme Lord, meditate on His divine form, the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, Shiva Bhagwan, Ganeshi, seeking their blessings, guidance and protection, that as we relate these kathas of Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran, we should be true to the text, true to what Bhagavan is saying. And when we are listening, we are able to grasp the true meaning of what Bhagavat Mahapuran is saying. We begin with Bhagavat Sunita.
Riddhi Siddhi Data Siddhi Sadhan Varan Bhajan Sumira Varan Madan Kadan Kelan Ganapati Kripani Dhan Gyan Khani Anand Bhavan Dehu Mohi Vardhan Varno Bhasha Bhagavat Jai Shivanand Kand Bhutanath Bhavan Bhay Haran Bhakti Shai Nirvan Gaur Varan Mangal Karan He Braj Chandra Mukun
Braj Bhushan
He Braj Chandra Mukun ब्रजभूषण दूषण काटहु भव भय पंक चरण शरण ली आन कर जय 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 जगदीश सेवत शेष महेश अजय महिमा अमित अभेद वेद भेद जानत ने देहु मोहि वरदान राधा वर यह वर सदा प्रेम भरी मुस्कान नित चित में खट काट रहे मोही चाहिए कछुनाहि और वस्तु प्रभु जात की बसी रहे मन माहि यह बाकी जाति सदा लील कुटिया हाथ गायन के पीछे फिरत बाल बाल लिए मोर मुकुट शिर पर धरे कर मुरली उर्मा शीश मुकुट कटी एक पट या छवि सो नंद बस हृदय मम निशी दिवस गुरु पद रज दर्शी कहो भागवत की कथा सो सुखदेव मुनीश कवि सो परीक्षित अति
निगम कल्पतरो गलितं फलम् सुखमुखादमितद्रवसंयुतम् इवत भागवतम् रसमालयम् मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भागवत बोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराण की जय श्री राधा रानी की जय। A few nights ago, couple nights ago, we read that wonderful katha of a very great personality known as Jar Bharat. fifth canto, seventh chapter, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All this deals, these chapters, with the katha of that great personality known as Jara Bharat. He was so great. Number one, he is the eldest son of Rishabh Bhagwan, descendant of Sri Krishna known as Rishabh Dev. Number two, he ruled the whole world, one king, in the age of Satyug. One king, the whole world, for 10 million years. He was so great a devotee that this previously the whole world was known as Ajanabh Varsh. And because of Bharatji, it became known as Bharat Varsh. Very briefly, the katha, most of you know, Jar Bharat gave up the rule after 10 million years, divided the entire kingdom and all his inheritance to his children, the sons. Then he went on the Gandaki Nadi, the river known as Gandaki Nadi, which contains the only authorized form of Bhagwan Sri Krishna known as Shaligram. It's also known as Shaligram Kshetra. In the ashram of Pulaha Muni, Pulaha and Paulasya Muni, and there, he'd already attained self-realization. But in order to attain God-realization, Brahma-gyan, he was doing bhakti. One day, a pregnant deer came to drink water in a river. While she was drinking the water, a lion roared. Being scared for her life, she tried to jump over the river, and in so doing, she had a miscarriage. The baby fell out from the womb. The mother ran away from there in some cave and died. And here the baby deer was drowning in the river. Jara Bharat saw this. Overcome with compassion, he dove into the water, took out the baby deer, started taking care, and became attached to the deer. So attached, instead of meditating on Sri Krishna, he would think about the deer while doing his sadhana, his spiritual divine bhakti suffered. He became so attached to the deer that when he was about to die, knowing he was going to die, he asked the disciples to bring the deer to him. Then putting his hand over the deer and playing with her, he told the disciples, "I love this deer very much. Please take good care of her. I'm about to leave." And he died, his mind being attached to the deer. It's a divine philosophy that wherever our mind, whatever we remember, yam yam vapi smaram bhavam tyajatyante kalevaram tam tamevaiti kaunteya sada tad bhava bhavitah. Sri Krishna is saying to Arjuna, chapter 8, verse 6, Gita, whatever we remember, remember, when the life leaves the body, whatever we remember at that time, that is what we're going to attain, what we're going to become in the next life. And what are we going to remember? The person or object we are attached to, we love that we are attached to. That's what we're going to remember. You're attached to Bhagwan, you will attain Bhagwan. Mostly, as in the case with us worldly people under Maya, we remember our worldly relations. Because of ignorance, agyan, we identify with the physical body and we get attached in the material world and we keep rotating in 8.4 million forms of life from beginningless time. Jara Bharat, because he remember the deer, so being so attached to the deer, was born as a deer in the next life. But even though he was born as a deer, in the body of a deer, he retained all the knowledge that he had acquired. His bhakti was so great, he had attained self-realization. And his bhakti was very high. So from, as a baby, he renounced all the other dears, mother, everyone, and went in the same ashram that he was doing bhakti on the bank of the Gandaki Nadi, and will only eat the leftovers of the saints and sages there, their jutan. Very quickly, due to the blessing of that jutan, uchisht, I spoke about last night, he attained the ultimate aim of godlization, Brahma Gyan. He gave up the body of a deer, and the next life he was born in the home of a Brahman. Who was in the lineage of the mind-born son of Brahma, Angira. Angira Muni. He was born in that lineage. That Brahman. And so, Bharatji now had complete knowledge. He had attained God-realization. He had become a saint. And being afraid that, remember what happened in the past life, getting attached to a deer and having fell so much that he, even though he had attained complete knowledge, when one attains God realization, everything that Sri Krishna has, he gives to that soul. Everything. Dadami buddhi yogam tam yena mam upayanti te. Chapter 10, verse 10, Gita. Everything Sri Krishna has, divine knowledge, divine bliss, divine vision, divine, everything divine, he gives to that soul, that saint. So Bharatji, Jar Bharat had complete, full knowledge, divine knowledge, not book knowledge, realized. And so being afraid, he pretended, even though he was so knowledgeable, to be the greatest fool, illiterate, but not take education. No matter how much the father tried to teach him, he would do the complete opposite. Pretended to be deaf, dumb, a brute, an animal in the form of human being. Was only pretending. I told you last night, God and the saints, when they come in the world, they hide themselves. Gopaniyam, 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 prayatnataha. No one should know. Only deserving souls, those who are deserving and have acquired the blessing of God or that saint, will realize who they are. Otherwise, no one can know. I mentioned his father had died before he could get knowledge, and the brothers didn't care, thinking him to be a great fool. Bharatji left the home. He was wandering, he would sleep on the ground. His body became pasted with dirt. He would not take bath. He wore only a piece of cloth around the loin, it's called a langot. That had become very dirty. Even his janeu, the tread, the sacred tread of the twice born, had become very dirty. Once, some tribal people, they were about, they wanted to perform a sacrifice to Bhadra Kali, Mahakali. They were looking for a human being to sacrifice, a man. And so they saw Bharat and seen him to be strong and young. They tied him up, took him to their village, gave him a bath, put on clean clothes, mala, all kind of chandan and all, everything. Worshipped him in that way for a sacrifice. Took a long, sharp sword. The chief of the tribal people had become the priest and was about to sacrifice Bharat, Jar Bharat, when the Devi appeared. They had placed him before the murti of the Devi, the statue. But when you try to harm a devotee of Bhagawan, that same action will befall you. You will befall in the same thoughts, the same way you think and want to harm, that will befall you also. God gets very angry. He never forgives anyone who tries, even in thought, has negative thought about a true devotee of His. The Devi appeared and took that sword and lopped off the head of everyone with her retinue, drank the blood, and she became intoxicated and danced and was singing loudly. Then she disappeared. Ab yaha katha aage chalenge, we'll go forward from there in this katha now. Just wanted to give introduction of where we reached. So in the little booklets you have, turn to page 13. कृपा करू बरसाने वारी तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी
कृपा करू बरसाने वारी तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी.
A true devotee of the Lord is into Radha Rani, the other form, the indispensable form of Sri Krishna Himself, O Radharani, O Divine Mother of the Universe, kindly shower Your grace upon me. Your grace itself personified. You can do nothing but kripa, grace.
Kripa karu barsane wali, teri kripa ka bharosa bhari. तेरा मन है कृपा का प्यारी, तेरा तन है कृपा का प्यारी,
तेरा मन है कृपा का प्यारी, तेरा तन है कृपा का प्यारी.
तेरी कृपा तो, तेरी कृपा तो कृपा है प्यारी, तेरा कोप भी कृपा है प्यारी,
तेरी कृपा तो कृपा है प्यारी, तेरा कोप भी कृपा है प्यारी.
तेरी कृपा चाह बनवारी, तेरी कृपा की है बलिहारी, ओ कृपा करु बरसाने वाली, तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी,
कृपा करु बरसाने वाली, तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी.
अथ सिंधु सौवीर पते रहो गण्यस्य व्रजातिक्षु मत्स्यास्तटे तत्कुलपतिना शिव का वाह पुरुषान् वेषनम समये देवेनो साधितः स्वादिज्वर उपलभेश पीवा युवा संघनांग तेरी कृपा कृपा करु बरसाने वाली तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी तेरी कृपा चाह बनवारी ऐसी कृपा पर वारी वारी तेरी कृपा की है बलिहारी कृपा पर कृपा करे प्यारी ऐसी कृपा पर वारी वारी
कृपा पर कृपा करे प्यारी ऐसी कृपा पर वारी वारी
कृपा करु बरसाने वारी तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी
कृपा करु बरसाने
मुझ पर कृपा करु प्यारी तब जानू तू कृपालु प्यारी
मुझ पर कृपा करु प्यारी तब जानू तू कृपालु प्यारी
तेरी कृपा पाके पिय प्यारी बनी गए हैं कृपालु प्यारी कृपा करु बरसाने वाली तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी
कृपा करु बरसाने वाली तेरी कृपा का भरोसा भारी
राधा कृष्ण भगवान की जय।
उसी समय एक राजा थे रहुगण। राजा का नाम थे रहुगण। एक बार रहुगण को लेके जा रहे थे डोली में महर्षि कपिल को मिलने के लिए, आध्यात्मिक ज्ञान को प्राप्त करने के लिए। तो उस डोली का एक आदमी कम था, तो एक सुमति नदी के पास में उन्होंने भरत जी को देखा, वो संत वो ऋषि, और सोचे कि बलवान है जवान है, तो उन्हें आज्ञा दी कि ये डोली कंधे पर रखो चलो। There was a king by the name of Rahugan. At the same time that Bharatji was in this world, there was a king by the name of Rahugan. Once this king was taken on a palanquin, doli, palanquin. His servants was taking him, ministers, etc., to meet that saint, the Maharishi Kapil, to acquire spiritual knowledge. On the way, close to the Ikshumati River, they had come, one person had gotten less in the palanquin to carry it, gotten sick or something. So they saw this young man, very strongly built, being young and powerfully built and taught, he is strong enough to carry a load like a donkey, like an ox. So they ordered him, they went and brought him and ordered him, you have to help us carry. Serve the king, you're a servant. Everyone in the kingdom of Rahugan are his servants. So the king has ordered you to take the palanquin, to put it on your shoulder. Lekin, kyunki Bharat ji भगवान में नशे के नशे में थे. जब कोई भक्त बन जाते हैं तो उस भक्ति उस आनंद में उसके नशा में ऐसे जैसे कोई संसार में नशीले होते हैं, खूब शराब पीते हैं, इस तरह से चलते हैं, तो ऐसे संत लोग भी चलते हैं जो वो रस को पीते हैं. तो भरत हमेशा श्री कृष्ण उनके मन में थे और उस आनंद में ऐसे झूम झूम के चलते. तो ऐसे चाल में तो वो पाल वो जो डोली ऊपर नीचे ऐसे चलते. नाउ व्हेन समवन ड्रिंक्स द डिवाइन नेक्टर ऑफ भगवान, व्हेन वन अटेन्स भक्ति, not the jnani, not the yogi, not the karmi, bhakt, only a bhakt drinks the divine nectar. He becomes a rasik. Rasik means a drink of ras. Shri Krishna is a ras and he is a rasik also. In the Vedas, there's a Ved mantra, रसो वै सहर सग्वम हे वायम लब्ध्वा नंदी भावति. तैतिरीय उपनिषद चैप्टर 2 वर्स 7. द वेदास आर सेइंग श्री कृष्ण इज रस. रसो वै सह, ही इज रस एंड ही इज आल्सो रसिक. रसिक शिरो मनी द टॉप मोस्ट ऑफ दैट ड्रिंक, द ड्रिंक ऑफ दैट रस, दैट डिवाइन नेक्टर, डिवाइन ब्लिस. सो दो सेइंग्स हु हैव अटेन्ड the divine bliss of Sri Radha Krishna through bhakti, they are called rasik, topmost among saints. There's no higher than them. They become intoxicated. Just like a person drinks alcohol in the world and in the world and becomes drunk, so he stumbles as he walks. So a saint having become intoxicated in divine bliss, he looks like a drunk person. He walks in the sways and walk in the same way. So Bharat ji, he is in that intoxication of the divine bliss of Sri Krishna. So he is swaying and walking like a drunk man. And the palanquin is going up and down, up and down. So Raja Rahugan ne kaha, ye kya ho raha hai? Aap log kya kar rahe? So the king inside that palanquin shouted, hey, what is happening to you people? Woh log ne kaha, Maharaj, hamare dosh nahi hai. Ye jo naya aadmi humne laya, wohi seedhe nahi chal sakta. Isko daata hum log ne. So the other people who were hauling the palanquin, they said, oh king, hey Raja, it's not our fault. Is this new person that we got? He is like a drunk man. He is walking all over the place and we are scolding him. He's not listening. He just, we don't know what's happening. To yaha Rahu Ganne, I say, dhang mein aise bole, ki hey, आप बहुत अफसोस की बात है, हे भाई साहब, आप बहुत लंबे समय ये डोली को लेके आया, बहुत थक गया और आप बलवान नहीं है, जवान नहीं है, बहुत बूढ़े हैं ना, इसलिए आप ऐसा करते हैं. सो नाउ द किंग, he's taunting. Very sarcastically he says, with taunting in the verse where he starts scolding. Bharat, Jar Bharat, that great saint. He says sarcastically, what a pity, my brother, that you have been taking this doli, this palanquin from so far. Bharatji had just joined. That you have become extremely tired, na? And oh, you are not a strong fellow, you are so weak. Bharat was very strong. And plus, you're an old man. And in this way, he taunted him in all kinds of ways. Bharat, even though he was being taunted like this, kuch bola hi nahi. Kyunki apne ko sharir nahi maana. Sant log, achha bhi bole, bura bhi bole, kuch nahi. One who has attained God realization, he no longer identifies with the body. He is a soul, atma. He's realized I am the soul. And the soul is indestructible. One of the definition of a saint, a true saint, is that he takes abuse as well as praise in the same way. He's neutral. Whether you abuse him, whether you praise, same thing. You could cast in the dirtiest way. You can even try to harm him. He doesn't, because he's not a body. He's gone beyond. We people, little things, somebody say, and we get so angry. Why? Because we identify with the body. We don't have the knowledge that we are the soul, atma. If we understand, if we gain that knowledge, not reading a book or hearing a lecture, but realize, Nainam chindanti shastrani, nainam dahati pavaka, na chainam kledayantyapu, na shoshayati marutah, achhedyo yamadahyo hya, makledyo shosha evacha, nitya sarvastharu chaloyam sanatana. Gita, chapter 2, verse 23 and 24. Shri Krishna is saying, the jivatma, the individual soul, who we are. We're not the body. We're soul atma. The soul cannot be cut by any weapon. It cannot be burned by fire. It cannot be wet by water nor dried by the wind. It is the same forever. You can curse it. You can do whatever. The soul is a non-experiencer. So when one realizes I'm the soul atma, Tulya ninda stutir mauni santushto yena kena chit aniketah stiramatir bhaktiman me priyo naraha. This is definition for a saint. That he takes abuse, whether he abuse or praise alike. Tulya ninda stutir mauni. Whatever he gets in the world, he's happy all the time. Whether he gets or doesn't get. He has no feeling of ownership of anything. He's all merciful, kind, and ever devoted to God. So, nothing happened to Bharatji. Rahugan kitne daantne ke baad, fir bhi ye dholi aisa idhar udhar chalte to bahut krodh aa gaya. Aur kaha bahut zor se. कि आप जिंदा हो कि मर गया, लाश है लाश, आप मुझे इनकार किया, मैं राजा हूं इसलिए आपको ऐसा बोलना पड़ेगा और दंड देना पड़ेगा. आफ्टर स्कोलन भरत जी लाइक दिस, भरत डिड नॉट रिप्लाई, जर भरत. But he continued, he is in that nashe, in that intoxication of divine love, swain. So Rahugan, King Rahugan, got so angry that he shouted really angrily, you, though living, you are like a dead man.
You're alive, but you're actually dead. What is this thing? You have transgressed. I am your king. I have commanded you and you have transgressed all my commands. Just as Yamraj punishes sinners, I should punish you. This way you are neglecting my orders. Ab Rahugan, wo raja the. To us raj mein abhiman ki nashe mein वो किसी के परवाह नहीं है. बिकॉज Rahugan इज ए किंग सो ही इज वेरी प्राउड. ही हैज दिस प्राउड, दिस प्राइड एंड मिक्स विद दैट एंगर ही इज कॉल्ड इन द वर्स्ट वे दैट ग्रेट सेज, दैट ग्रेट सेंट जर भरत. तो भरत जी इसकी परवाह वैसे नहीं किया, लेकिन वो Rahugan की के कल्याण के लिए कुछ बोले. So Bharatji didn't mind what the king said. A saint doesn't mind, doesn't hurt because he's not a body. But for the welfare of that king, he said something to him. What did he say? We'll hear. Let's turn again to page 13. Same page. A devotee saying, "He Shri Krishna, O mere Nandanandan, O son of Nanda Baba Shri Krishna, please make me your own, apna banale, mohi banale. Reveal to the servant of yours your darshan. Let me see a little bit of you. Let me see you. Bless me with your seva, your service, etc." मेरे नंदनन मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन अपना बना ले मोहि मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन तरस दिखा दे टुक मेरे नंदनंदन
तरस दिखा दे टुक मेरे नंदनंदन
मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन
मेरे
निज सेवा दे मोहि मेरे नंदनंदन
निज सेवा दे मोहि मेरे नंदनंदन
ओ मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन
मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे
जन सेवा दे मोहि मेरे नंदनंदन
जन सेवा दे मोहि मेरे नंदनंदन
मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन अपना बना ले मोहि मेरे नंदनंदन
मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन
त्वयोदितं व्यक्त मवे प्रलब्धं भर्तो समे स्याद देवीर यन्तुर्यदि स्यादधि गम्यमध्वा पिवेत्ति राशौ नविदम् प्रवादः निद्रारतिर्मन्युरहं मदः शुचोदेन जात मेरे नंदनंदन मेरे नंदनंदन अपना बना ले मोहि
मेरे नंद नंदन
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन हम लाभ ना ले मोही मेरे नंद नंदन
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन
तू ही मेरा मैं भी तेरा मेरे नंद नंदन
तू ही मेरा मैं भी तेरा मेरे नंद नंदन
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन
माना मैं हूँ माही मैं ना भूलू कभू तो ही मेरे नंद नंदन
मैं ना भूलू कभू तो ही
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन अपना बना ले मोही मेरे नंद नंदन
मेरे नंद नंदन मेरे नंद नंदन अपना बना ले मोही मेरे नंद नंदन
बोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। भरत जी ने बहुत मीठी आवाज से बहुत नरम और मीठी आवाज से कहा कि हे राजन जो आपने कहा अभी ये कोई झूठ नहीं बोले क्योंकि मैं अभी थकान है ही नहीं मेरे शरीर में और ना तो बहुत दूर से ये डोली लाया। हे बड़े राजा आपने जो कहा ये मेरे बारे में है ही नहीं तो मैंने कुछ अनुभव मेरे कुछ अनुभव नहीं हुआ फील नहीं किया क्योंकि मैं अपने शरीर को नहीं माना। अगर कोई अपने को शरीर मानते तो गुस्सा आएंगे फील करेंगे लेकिन क्योंकि आपने शरीर के बारे में बोला तो हमारे ऊपर गए नहीं। सो नाउ भरत जी इज गिवन द हाईएस्ट टीचिंग्स with a very soft and sweet voice. He says, O king, what you have just said very sarcastically to me, I know why you are saying it. And what you hinted is true. I am in no way fatigued, tired, and I have not brought this palanquin from a very far place. When you were referring to me, the soul, the atma, I am not the body. Had you referred to me, I might have felt something, but you were referring to the body. And I do not identify with the body. We in the world, we are fearful. Every moment, our life is filled with fear, with strength, with stress, tension. All because we identify with the body. Those who no longer identify with the body. Jnani bhugate jnanate murak bhugate roya. Those who are truly knowledgeable, haven't realized I am the soul, the atma, nothing affects them. It's like the leaf of a lotus flower or many of you would know that this dashing leaf, when water falls on it, what happens? It rolls like a pearl, but it does not affect the leaf. It rolls and it just comes out. The same way on the lotus leaf, on the water on a duck's back, it just rolls off. It doesn't affect him. In the same way, whatever you have said is not about me. I am the soul, Atma. You're talking about a body being stout, strong, suffering from old age, sleep, attachment, pleasures of the senses, anger, vanity, ego, grief, anger, jealousy. These are all diseases of the body. The body has a beginning, the body has an end. Jatasu dhruvamitam dhruvam janmamitasya cha. Chapter 2, verse 27, Gita. That which takes birth must die, and that which die must take birth. This body takes birth. Every moment is getting old. It's going to suffer. It's eventually, it's going to destroy. It's going to die. But the soul, the Atma, always remains the same. It never changes. So when we identify with the body, then we get all these problems. Fear, greed, anger, jealousy, hatred, lust. Many of these diseases, this question was asked by Kaag Basundi Ji, by Guruji in the Ramayana, about diseases of the mind, Manas Rog. In the Sapta Prashna, very famous katha in the Ramayana, once Guruji Maharaj asked 7 questions to Kaag Basundi Ji. One of the questions was about diseases of the mind, Manas Rog.
काम बात कप लोभ अपारा क्रोध पित्त ने छाती जारा प्रीति करही चौकी हो उपजय संय पात दुखदाई जय राम श्री
राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम.
So he gives some, he tells about some of the diseases. Kaam baat kapha lobha para, krodh pitta nita chhati jara, preeti karai jauti nehu bhai, upajai sanya paat dukhdai. Many diseases he mentioned, greed, anger, jealousy, hatred, lust, delusion, many. But he says these trees are the 3 generals of that army. There are many, many diseases of the mind, Manas Rog. Many. But these are 3 big ones. Kaam, Krodh, Lobh. Kaam, lust, desire. Krodh, anger. Lobh, greed. He calls them 3 brothers. 3 bhai. And one who practices these 3, upajai sanya path, he gets a disease like hysteria and destroys him. Yet, narakatin dwar, in the Gita, these 3 are called 3 gateways to hell. Kaam, krodh, lobh. But there are many. There are big ones. But there are many, many.
Ram, Siya Ram, Siya Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Bolo Ram.
Ram, Siya Ram, Siya Ram, Jai Jai Ram,
Bolo Ram. Siya Ram, Siya Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Bolo
Ram. Siya Ram, Siya Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
मानस रोग कछुक मैं गाए है सबके लखी वीर लही पाए बोलो
राम सिया राम सिया राम जय जय राम सिया राम सिया राम जय जय राम.
मानस रोग कछुक मैं गाए. Oh, Guruji, Kaag Basundi Ji is saying, there are many diseases of the mind, many. I have told you only a few. Kachuk, my guy. Aur hai sabke, As long as we are under Maya, as long as we identify with the physical body, we don't know who we are. We have forgotten that I am the soul, the Atma. Then we have all the diseases of the mind: greed, anger, jealousy, hatred, lust, selfishness, delusion, many, many, all. Hai sabke baat lakhi biralan hi paaye. It is extremely difficult for us to see the worldly soul. What prevents us from seeing how bad we are? We can see how bad everybody else is, and we complain. We can find everybody's faults, but we can't find our own. Nobody sees their own faults. Why? We have something called abhiman, ego. The ego, the false pride, it doesn't allow us. You see, the intellect, buddhi, it is governed by this ego, this false pride. It doesn't allow us to see the reality. The more pride, the more ego we have, the more we think we are great. And we're better than everyone. We're worse, but we're better, we think. That ego. And that's why, if you want to do bhakti, you want to be a spiritual person, the first thing Gaurang Mahaprabhu says in his Shikshastak, Tinadapi Sunichena, one has to become humbler than a blade of grass. Once we have ego, we cannot do bhakti. Every little thing is going to make you angry. And once you get angry, what's going to happen? Krodhat bhavati sammoha, sammoha smriti vibhrama, smriti banshar buddhinasho, buddhinashar panashyati. Chapter 2, verse 63, Gita. From anger comes delusion. From delusion, loss of memory. When we lose our memory, we lose the power to discriminate, and everything is destroyed. So you're going to get angry all the time. When someone tells you a nice thing, or they're nice to you, or to do what you want, jai ho, jai ho. I love you. And they don't do what you want, they don't listen to you, oh, you get angry. You want to kill them. We lose everything. But if you become humble, realizing what the condition of the mind, that we are the most fallen, realizing deep inside. Look at the grass. You walk on the grass. What happens? When you walk on the grass, it bends. Jhuk jati. And when you go, it stands again. It never complains. Are you blind? Can't you see where you're going? Little thing, we get angry. The grass never complains. You look at somebody sometimes, a big problem. Trinad, humility is the foundation. Dinata, humility is the foundation of bhakti. Without humility, you can't even practice. It's very important. So, and it all comes because identifying with the physical body. All these things, grief, etc., will happen because you don't know who you are. Jo bhi shuruaat hai, iska ant hai. Whatever begins has an end, he says. And this body has a beginning, it has an end, not the soul. The soul is not destroyed even when the body is destroyed. Indestructible. आप कहते हैं कि मैं राजा हूं और आप हमारे दास. लेकिन राजा कौन और दास कौन? He says to Rahugan, hey king, you are saying that you are the king, ruler, and I'm your servant. But who is a servant and who is a king? इस जन्म में आप राजा है, अगले जन्म में दास बन जाएंगे और मैं आपका राजा बन जाऊंगा. In this lifetime, you are somebody, you are the king, and I am a servant. In the next life, you become a servant. I become the king, it changes. In this life, you are a husband, she is a wife, you scold, you do all kinds of things to her. Next life, she becomes the wife, and she do the same thing to you. What goes around, comes around. The law of karma The science is very, very sure. It's very strict. Whatever the actions you perform, we will have to bear the fruits. Avashyameva bhoktavyam kritam karma shubha shubham. Mahabharat, the scripture says, you will have to bear the fruits of your good action as well as bad action. So, ab bataiye. Ab kya milega aise karne se? What are you going to get by doing this, by ordering others and you're a king and all this thing? Pura gyan itna bure lecture diya. Bharat ji, I'm being a little bit brief here. A whole lecture he gave to Rahugan about the body and about the soul and about bhakti. अब ये पूरा लेक्चर सुन के वो रहुगण को ये क्या है तुरंत नीचे आ गया और भरत के श्री चरणों में गिर गया और पूछने लगे, आप कौन है इस वेश में? अपने को छिपाते हैं? अवधूत है? ये कौन है? क्या है? या वही कपल जो मैं मिलने जा रहा हूं, कौन है आप? Here in all this divine lecture, only a saint could, and it affected him. Not only he's given lecture, but it goes inside. Realizing that this was a great saint and being very embarrassed, immediately Rahugan jumped down from the palanquin, fell at the feet, fell. Putting his face, his head on the lotus feet of Bharatji, Jar Bharat, that great saint, shedding tears and begging for forgiveness. He says, who are you? In this disguise that you're wearing, this dirty clothes, this dirt as clothes, you're wearing the sacred thread of the twice born Dwij. Are you an avadhut? One who's shaken off all worldliness and all worldly ties? Obligations? If so, which one are you? Like Dattatreya, etc. Kaun hai? Agar aap, are you Kapil, that sage I'm going to meet that have come here for our good? Who are you? Main Indra ke baj se nahi darta, Shiv ke trishul se nahi darta, Yamraj ke dand se nahi darta. ये अग्निदेव के जितने शस्त्र है नहीं डरता, सूर्य नारायण चंद्रमा वायु कुबेर इसे से नहीं डरता, जितना मैं डरता हूं कि संत महापुरुष का अपमान किया. लिसन टू दीज वर्ड्स. रहुगण सेज, आई एम नॉट स्केर्ड, आई एम नॉट अफ्रेड ऑफ द त्रिशूल ऑफ शिव भगवान. आई एम नॉट अफ्रेड स्केर्ड ऑफ द रॉड ऑफ यमराज, the god of death, the thunderbolt of Indra, the weapons of Agnidev, the Surya Narayan Swami, Chandrama, the moon god, the god of wind, of Kuber, as I am afraid of disrespecting and insulting a true devotee of the Lord, a saint. The greatest sin anyone can commit, I told you last night, Bhagwan doesn't mind. Suno Suresh Raghunath Subhau Nij Aparad Risahi Nakahu. And Tulsidas ji saying in our mind, the Lord, his nature is such that he doesn't care when people curse and abuse. People do. He knows we are ignorant on the Maya. But Jo Aparad Bhagat Kar Karai Ram Rosh Pavak So Jarai. When one tries to harm a devotee of the Lord, Bhakt, thinks wrong, negative, God's anger is like a fire that will destroy everything. He never forgives that. So I am so scared because you're a devotee. I have recognized your fill. Bhare hai divya gyan. You have divine knowledge. Bahut lambi gunagan. In a very long way, he glorified Bharatji. हे महाराज, हे संत, आप मुझ पर कृपा कीजिए। जैसे हम लोग कृपा करो, कृपा करो, कृपा करो राधे, ऐसे कृपा मांग रहे। मैं अधम हूं, गुनहगार हूं, मुझ पर कृपा की दृष्टि डालो। आप बड़े दिव्य है, मैं जान लिया। ऐसे पाप होते हैं संतों की तरह, भक्त की तरह, तो कभी इसका वो भगवान भी माफ नहीं करेंगे। कोई माफ करेंगे तो वो संत ही करेंगे। He says, because of my pride of being a king, there's a pride that comes. When we have anything a little bit in the world extra, it brings pride. Tulsidasji says in the Ramayana,
नहीं को आस जन्मा जग माही, प्रभुता पाही जाही मग नाही। जय राम श्री राम,
कोवस जन्मा जग माही, प्रभुता पाही जाही मद नाही। तुलसीदास जी महाराज saying, there never was nor is nor will there be such a person in the world who've acquired something in excess, wealth, money, position, a king. Little position people get, you make them president in a little mandir, oh Bhagwan, it flies to the head. Imagine being the president of a place like America. Post, position, etc. And they have not become arrogant. Jahi madanahi. This is why the Christ is saying to the rich man in the Bible, it is easier for a camel to enter the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. Of course, there is no Christian that understands this. They read, but who can understand is a different thing. Reading book doesn't mean you know anything. You can have the whole Bible in your head, the whole Gita, the whole Bhagavat. But if you understand, words doesn't mean you understand anything. Quoting doesn't mean you know. Understanding means a different thing. So he says, if it pleases you, please shower your grace on me. Kripa karu, kripa karu. Shower your glance upon me, your grace, your most holy and the greatest of saints. This, because of myself, this pride I had being a ruler of man, I have committed a great, great sin by being disrespectful to you. Not even Bhagwan will forgive. If anyone has to forgive, the saint will forgive. No one will forgive. फिर जर भरत जी वो महापुरुष ने कुछ बोला, संत जी ने क्या बोले हम सुनेंगे। नाउ भरत जी रिप्लाइज टू हिम, व्हाट डज भरत जी से टू द सेंट टू किंग रहुगन, लेट्स हियर पेज 55। Chanting the name of Bhagwan is most important, especially in this age we live in. The Ramayana says, Kali Yuga Keval Hari Gun Gaha Gavat Nar Pavahi Bhavataha. In the age of Kali Yuga, only by chanting the name of the Lord, we can become free from the ocean of Maya. Kali Yuga Keval Hari Nama Adhara Sumiri Sumiri Nara Utarahu Para.
Kak Basundji saying to Guruji in the Kalyug Mahima, in the age of Kalyug, only by taking the name of the Lord and remembering the Lord, one can become free from the ocean of Maya and attain God-realization, the ultimate aim of life. In the age of Kalyug, the thing that is recommended, the only thing recommended, Ek Aadhar Ram Guna Gana, Kalyug Jogana Jagya Gyana. One cannot do yoga, cannot do gyan, cannot do jagya. Kak Basundji saying to Guruji, to what to do? Ek Aadhar Ram Guna Gana. Just chant the name of the Lord with love, with devotion, not like a parrot.
Hari bol, hari bol, hari bol. Hari bol, hari bol, hari bol.
Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol. Hari bol, hari bol, hari bol.
Hari bol bol lele hari mo Hari bol hari bol
hari bol bol lele hari mo Hari bol hari bol
jahan wahan jahan kahi muh khol Hari bol hari bol Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol.
Oh, hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol.
Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol.
Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol, hari bol.
Naved vadeshu hi tattva Vada prayena shabdho shuddho Chakasti sadhu natasya tattva Grahanaya sakshad vasiyasi Rapi vachah samasan Sapne viruktva Vihe midhe saukhyam Natasya heyanumittam swayam Hari bol, hari bol, hari bol Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol Hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol
Yaha naam ratan anmo Hari bol, hari bol,
yah naam ratan anmol Hari bol, hari bol
It bol, ut bol, jit bol Hari bol, hari bol
It bol, ut bol, jit bol Hari bol, hari bol
Aate jaate khaate peete jab bhi bol Hari bol, hari bol.
Aate jaate khaate peete jab bhi bol. Hari bol, hari bol.
Oh, hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol.
Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol.
Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol.
Oh, hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol.
Hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol, hari bol,
hari bol,
भरत जी वो बड़े संत ने कहा कि हे राजन आप तो अज्ञानी हैं
लेकिन ऐसे वाक्य बोलते हैं कि कोई ज्ञानी बड़े ज्ञानी हो, इसलिए इस तरह से बातें करते हैं कि कोई राजा हो और कोई दास हो। अगर ज्ञान नहीं है तो नहीं ऐसा बोलेंगे। भरत जी सेज, ओ किंग, डू यू आर वेरी इग्नोरेंट, यू डू नॉट हैव ट्रू नॉलेज, यू आइडेंटिफाई विद द बॉडी, यू मेक स्पीचेस एज डू यू आर अ नॉलेजेबल पीपल इन द वर्ल्ड, दे गेट अ PhD, दे गेट अ BSc, सम काइंड ऑफ डिग्री एंड द थिंग हा आई नो एवरीथिंग, Somebody reads the Ramayana, I know Ramayana. Somebody read Gita, I know Gita. Really? Are bhaiya, Tulsidas ji says in the Ramayana, Soi janahi jehi dehu janai, janat tumhi tumhi huay jai. He who knows Ramayana has become Ram. In other words, to know what is written in Ramayana, you have to become Ram, you have to attain God-realization. A worldly person can never know what is in Ramayana. You know the story Ramayana, not what is in Ramayana. Tulsidas ji says, I have put all the philosophy of all the Vedas, Upanishad in this Ramayana. Ved Sammat. But how to take it out? We can know the whole Ramayana from beginning to end. Kahani, Katha. The story, everybody knows the story, but what is in the Ramayana? Everything is there. Sab kuch hai usme. To know Gita, you have to become Arjun, Vedavyas. Just reading Gita doesn't mean you know. People, little children in India, 5 years, 7 years, they know the whole Gita by mind, by heart they can say it. Doesn't mean they have attained God-realization. No. Nothing. So, you speak as though you are someone knowledgeable, yet you are talking about somebody is a king and some is a servant. If you had true knowledge, you will see with the eye of equality. The one who has true knowledge has realized, I am the soul, Atma. He sees with the eye of equality everywhere, the soul. He does not see difference whether someone is a Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, whether it's an elephant, a dog, a cat, a donkey, a tree even, because he sees the soul everywhere. Not only that, but he sees Bhagwan everywhere. Siya Ram mai sab jag jani, karahu pranam jori jug pani. Like Hanumanji, he sees the beloved Sitaram in every particle of the world. And putting his hands together, he does pranam. Then you have knowledge. तो जब तक माया के अंदर में सत्व गुण रजोगुण तमोगुण, तो पाप ही करेंगे, पाप ही करेंगे। ये मन है सब पापों का घर है। As long as we under माया, माया has three qualities, सत्व गुण रजोगुण तमोगुण, three qualities, अजाम एकाम लोहित शुक्ल कृष्णाम बहवी प्रजा सृजमानाम स्वरूपाः अजो हे को जुषमानुनुशेति जहातिनाम भुक्त भोगाम अजोन्यः। श्वेताश्वतरोपनिषद चैप्टर 4 verse 5, द वेद से माया हैज थ्री क्वालिटीज, सत्वगुण रजोगुण तमोगुण, दे हैव देयर कंट्रोल ओवर द वर्ल्डली सोल, ओवर द माइंड। दिस माया, दिस मन, दिस थिंग वी कॉल माइंड इज क्रिएटेड बाय माया, इट्स अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ माया and is governed by Maya, the three qualities. As long as we are under the control of Maya, we do nothing but sin, pap. Every moment we are thinking wrong thoughts is the mind. You see, people generally think, I didn't do anything wrong physically. I didn't curse anyone, I didn't steal physically. I didn't beat up anyone, I didn't kill anyone. I didn't drink alcohol, I didn't eat meat. So I didn't commit any sin physically. So I'm not a sinner. I can't think myself being a papi, a sinner. Okay. First to begin, what or who is the performer of the action? Is the What God's note? Does he know the physical? Is it our hand, feet, mouth, eyes, nose? No. The Vedas say, Man eva manushanam karnam bandhamokshayoho. Brahma Bindu Upanishad, second mantra. Man, the mind, eva, alone. Manushyanam, human beings. Karnam is the cause, bandhan of bondage, moksh, liberation. The Vedas are saying, there's many places, Narad Puran, Narad Pancharatra, etc., many Upanishad. The mind alone is the cause of bondage as well as liberation. The mind is the performer of the action. God knows only our thoughts and ideas and rewards and punishes us accordingly. Now tell me, in your mind, are we thinking wonderful thoughts every moment? Every moment we're thinking wrong thoughts, dirty thoughts. Somebody sees somebody, they don't like that person. Somebody, that person may have done something or said something about them. I wish she will die. I wish she would go in the road and a car will smash her. And when she comes in front of you, Sitaram, Sitaram, for a long time I haven't seen you. Have a seat. Jai Ho. And which one God is going to note? The dirty, nasty thought in our mind that she should go and die, or the sweet word from the mouth, have a nice seat. God notes the thought. This is the performer. See, we don't know. That's why we can't think like that. It is mind. And being on the Maya, one, it is filled uncountable lifetime of sin. It's called Sanchit Pap. We are beginningless, the soul, the Atma. This body, we have a subtle body. There are three bodies. Stool Sharir, Sukshma Sharir, Karana Sharir. Stool Sharir, the gross body. When we die, that remains here. The Sukshma Sharir, the senses, mind, intellect, etc., goes with us wherever we go. And when there's Mahapralay, complete dissolution, even the Sukshma Sharir, the subtle body is also destroyed. Only Karana Sharir remains, the impressions of all the actions we have ever performed. That alone stays. Mind doesn't stay, intellect doesn't stay. So even Mahapralay, the actions we have performed, we start back when creation starts, we start back from the same position that it finished. Very deep philosophy. Time to go on and talk about this in detail, it takes a lot of time. Anyhow, so being governed by Maya, the three qualities of Maya, it has its control on the mind. Mind itself is a product of Maya. And so, we get tossed about with the three qualities of Maya. Sometimes the three qualities, they keep mixing and intermingling. Like three wrestlers in a ring. One tumbles the second down. The third tumbles the first. The second tumbles the third, etc. One is always predominating. And the one that predominates determines how we think, how we feel at that time. People say, oh, you're so moody. Moody? Where does mood come from? Huh? People have a saying in the world, my blood didn't take that person. Blood? Nothing to do with blood, bhaiya. Blood is an inert object. It doesn't have life. It all has to do with the three modes of Maya. When the qualities of two people are matching, I like that person. Friendship comes. You think that person is a good person. You could be tamasic and you think it's a very good person because you're matching. You see, that's why we make wrong judgment. That's why it says, don't judge. Don't judge a book by its cover. Because how we are, that's how we're going to judge. We have wonderful thoughts about because the qualities are matching. Any difference comes, that friendship finishes. And that person could be sattvic and you're thinking is the worst person because you're not matching. It determines how we feel. When the sattvic quality is predominating, high and noble thought will fill our mind. When the rajasic quality is predominating, we are ambitious, hopeful, greed, all these things will come. And when the tamasic quality is predominating, oh, lazy, lack incentive, you want to sleep. Those who like to sleep plenty. We love to sleep. Sleep is important. It's needed to keep, to the body has to be given rest, but too much is bad. The Gita, Sri Krishna says, to sleep too little is bad, to sleep too much is also bad. It brings more tamasic qualities. And too little is also bad, the body is going to suffer. One should not eat too much, nor eat too little, drink too much, nor drink too little, sleep too much, nor sleep too little. Evil thoughts come, the desire to eat meat, to drink alcohol, those kind of thoughts, because the mind is very dirty, tamasic. Argue, fight, quarrel, tamasic. So this is what happens because we are under the control of Maya. So that same, but that same mind, the mind is very important. Because of this mind, we have been rotating in 8.4 million forms of life. The mind, my Guru, Jagat Guru Tam Sri Kripalu Mahaprabhu says, the mind is our greatest enemy. Nobody can do you anything. No neighbor, no, nobody can do you anything. Our mind. Everything that happens to us is because of our mind. Because of this mind, we go to heaven. Because of this mind, we come in the material world. Because of this mind, we go to hell. We keep rotating in 8.4 million forms of life, all because of this thing called mind, man. So it's our greatest enemy, but we can make it our friend. We have to make the same mind our friend, because we need this mind to do bhakti. Doing bhakti with the physical sense organ is no bhakti. Bhakti is to be done with the mind, the mind. We have to meditate on God, love God. You can't do it with hand, foot, mouth. You can't love with that. You love with the heart, the mind. So we have to make the mind our friend, because this mind will take us to Bhagawan, will free us from this material avagaman, this endless cycle of birth and death, rotating in 8.4 million forms of life. That will happen, how? When we realize that we are the soul, the Atma. Realizing that you're not first Guru ke paas jao, Guru ke paas. We have to go to a true saint. Knowledge doesn't come from reading book. True knowledge. In the Ramayana we are told,
Ram, Siya Ram, Siya Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Bolo Ram.
Siya Ram, Siya Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Oh, Binu Sat Sang Vivek Na Hoi. Ram Kripa Binu Sulabhan Soi. Bolo Ram. Bhakti Swatanta Sakal Sukhani Binu Sat Sang Na Paavahi Prani. Bolo Ram.
भरत जी कहते हैं कि हे राजन, संतों के श्री चरणों के अब गुरु को भगवान को मानकर, साक्षात भगवान को मानकर इनकी भक्ति करो, तो जितने ये मन की शत्रु है ये सब अपने आप नष्ट हो जाएगा. Knowing the गुरु, seeing the Guru as Bhagwan personified, knowing the Guru to be God personified, as God himself, and worshiping the Guru like Bhagavan, then only all this true knowledge will come. Binu Satyasang. Sat means sant, saint. Sang means association. Only when we associate with a true saint, a true guru, we'll acquire true knowledge. And how are we going to get that association? Ram Kripa. Only when God will shower his grace. Bhakti, divine love, is free from all paths. It doesn't require any path. Every path requires bhakti, gyan, yoga, karma. Everybody requires bhakti. Bhakti doesn't require anybody's help. It's a storehouse of all happiness. But binu satyasanga na paavahi prani. Without association of a saint who has attained that divine love, divine bliss of God, no soul can attain it. We have to surrender to a true guru. Shri Krishna tells us in Gita, Tad virapranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattva darshinah. Chapter 4, verse 34, Gita. If you are so fortunate to meet the true guru, a real guru, bona fide saint, who is a real guru? We need a guru. Guru is most important, but he has to be qualified. And Sri Krishna gives the qualification here. He says, Jnaninaha, number one. Number two, Tattvadarshinaha. Number one, Jnaninaha, means he has complete knowledge of all the Vedas, all the scriptures. Not just Ramayana, not just Gita, all complete knowledge. Plus, he's able to make us understand. And secondly, Tattva Darshinaha, which is even more important. He has seen God. He has attained a divine knowledge, divine bliss, divine love. He has seen Tattva Darshinaha. He has attained that divine love, divine vision, divine bliss of God. If you are so fortunate to meet the true Guru, what do you do? Number one, Tad Viripranipatena, completely surrender to him. Number two, Pariprasnena, because we have doubts, get knowledge, true knowledge from him by asking him question. You go to the wrong person, you will get more doubtful. You will just become more ignorant. We have to ask, but ask him the truth, the right person. And sevaya, serve him. Knowing him to be God personified. The Veda says, yasya deva parabhakti yatha deva tatha guru. Tasyate katita hyarta prakashyante mahatmanah. Shvetashvatara Upanishad, chapter 6, verse 23. We have to worship the true Guru, knowing him to be God personified. Worship him in the same way, with the same love, as you will worship Bhagawan. We have to worship the preceptor, the saint, the true Guru, like God himself. Then we will attain that knowledge. Sri Krishna is telling us in the Gita also. You can go home and read it. Chapter 4, verse 34. Google it if you don't have a Gita. People give all kind of crazy meaning, but you should get the gist of the meaning. You might not get the whole correct meaning. Finally, Bharatji says, beautiful, very beautiful shlok. Rahu ganai tat tapasa nayati na che jaya nirvapana grihadva na chandasa nai vajanak ji suryai bina mahat padar jo bhishekam. O Rahugan, not true tapasya. Rahu ganai tat tapasa nayati na che jaya, not through the performance of Vedic rites and rituals. Yagna. Not true, one may be doing tapasya with the four fires burning in all direction. Not true, charity. Not through the Vedic rites and ritual, worshipping of the devatas, etc. Can one attain the ultimate aim of life except by reverently bearing himself with the lotus, dust of the lotus feet of a true saint, a true guru. महत्पादरजोभिषेकम्, फिफ्थ कांटो 12th चैप्टर 12th वर्स श्रीमद् भागवत महापुराण, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्स. ओनली व्हेन वी रेवरेंटली सरेंडर टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ अ ट्रू सेंट. महत्पादरजोभिषेकम् will we become free from maya, will you attain divine knowledge, divine bliss, will you attain everything, otherwise impossible. There's much more, but time we'll hear some other time. Bole Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai, Srimad Sadguru Sarkar ki jai, Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran ki jai, Umapati Mahadev ki jai.